You can create a transform task directly from the pipeline by selecting Transform Data. Give a name to the task and, optionally, add a description. When done, click Create. Here, you can make two types of transformations. The first type is the pass-through transformation. Select the datasets and add them to the target. You can select an individual dataset and add it twice. In this case, we add the customer dataset again. For example, you may have individual and business customers, and you would like to separate them. When you have defined your target structure, you can select the Datasets tab to edit it. In this case, we want to apply a filter to the Customer ID dataset. We filter the column Contact Title, so if the contact title is null, the customer will be added in the individual customer column. Once you've built your expression, you can select OK to apply the changes. In this case, since the customer is an individual, we don't need the company name. You can remove columns by clicking the Remove button. Removed columns can be shown by clicking the Show Removed Columns button. If you want to restore the removed columns, you can click the Revert button. You can edit columns by selecting them and clicking the Edit button. In this case, we are going to change the data type from string to numeric. The annotation next to the affected area indicates that there is an explicit transformation rule on the data type of this column. You can always revert the changes you made by clicking the Revert button. In the Orders dataset, we are going to remove the ship columns and keep only the ship name column as a reference. Under Settings, you can change the target database, the data asset schema, and the internal schema. The Materialized option creates a physical table to store the data. In this case, we select the Non-Materialized option. This will reduce the processing requirements on the target. You also have the option to keep historical records and an archive of change records. When done, click OK. After that, you can apply rules to transform your data. You can see this in detail in a separate video. Now, we are going to show how to use custom SQL to leverage a large variety of transformation requirements. Select the source dataset and then click the Add SQL-based dataset button. Here, you can add your SQL. You can select your dataset and add columns to it. Or, you can add your own SQL. Once you've added your SQL, you can add a dataset name and, optionally, a description. Click on the Extract Parameters button. Once you've extracted the parameters, you can click the Describe Table button. This will return the results of your SQL so that you can validate and make sure the structure looks appropriate. When done, click OK. You can add more datasets. In this case, we select the Orders dataset. We add SQL to insert a custom list of shipping addresses. Then, we click Extract Parameters. When done, we add a dataset name, and then we click on the Describe Table button. When done, click OK. Clicking on the Datasets tab, you now have the ability to apply rules to your dataset. For this, the SQL could be an initial starting point, and then you can apply rules on top of that SQL. For example, to change the dataset case, add strings, and so on. One thing that you must do is define keys for these datasets generated with SQL. If you validate the datasets now, you'll get an error because these two datasets don't have keys. So, you need to assign a key for both datasets. Now that the structure is more complex, you need to materialize the dataset. If the SQL is not complex, you can leave it as non-materialized. However, if you want to track the history of this SQL so that you can see changes over time in the data, you have to materialize this dataset. In the settings for a dataset, you can override the settings for a specific dataset that were defined in the data asset settings. In this case, we select On in the Materialized drop-down menu. When you select this option, you can also select if you want to track history or not. In this case, the history is already turned on in the data asset setting. When done, you can click Prepare to prepare the schema. You can look at the generated SQL. Here, you can see the creation of artifacts generated from your custom SQL. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.